Hello to everyone. In this lecture, we will discuss the graph of inverse trigonometric functions of some identities and formulas which are in standard format. So this is the third lecture of ITF, and in this lecture we will go through to learn how to find the graph with holding the conditions of domain and range, that is also called in balancing in ITF chapter. So it is very important for JE point of view, because from here we can get the how the differentiability exists and differentiability does not exist. The points where differentiability does not exist, we can find the sharp corners and how the definition changes in different sections. So let's start. This is called balancing of equations, or also called we will draw the graph with balancing. In the graph, while drawing, we have required here some concepts of concavity and convexity also, which is the part of differentiation. Later on, we will discuss in detail. Now let's start. So we have collected here six standard questions. In the form of questions, we will take some six different ITF expressions, and hence then we go for detailed analysis in this. Let's start. So here there are number one is sine inverse 2x upon 1 plus x square, you know, and here that what we call, that is cos inverse 1 minus x square upon 1 plus x square. Then third is tan inverse 2x upon 1 minus x square. Fourth is tan inverse 3x minus x cube upon 1 minus 3x square. And fifth, sin inverse 3x minus 4x cube, and cos inverse 3x minus 4x cube. So let's start. If you check here, that as we know that above mentioned six curves are non-periodic, as you know, inverse trigonometric functions are non-periodic here, but have restricted domain and range. So we shall first define each curve for its domain, range, and then sketch the curve. So sketch of number one, y equal to sine inverse 2x upon 1 plus x square. So for this, you know, the domain of sine inverse is sine inverse 2x upon 1 plus x square. This is the function here. Here this is the function fx. Okay. And what do you see here? That is 2x upon 1 plus x square. 1 plus x square, that is mod, is less or equal to 1. Less or equal to 1. That it means, because sine inverse x is 1 minus minus 1 to plus 1. Its domain is lies between minus 1 to plus 1. So that's we say 2x upon 1 minus x square, 2x upon 1 plus x square lies with mod that is less than 1. So that what we say here, 2x upon 1 plus x square, and hence we say mod is less than or equal to 1. So we can solve now, 2x is less or equal to x square plus 1, and hence we say x square minus 2x and plus 1 is greater or equal to 0, and this shows that x minus 1 whole square is greater or equal to 0, which is of course, and this provides that here we say x belongs to all real number. So if x belongs to all real number, now we are free to assume that x equal to tan theta, because this substitution is more appropriate rather than other. Why so? Because theta, the range of tan theta is all real number, hence we say, and its domain is all real, this one. So that's why we can say x belongs to all real number. So for the curve which is given, that is all real number domain, so no restriction is there. So better just assume it's x equal to tan theta. So if you are assuming x equal to tan theta, then you can say theta equal to, that is tan inverse x, theta equal to tan inverse x. Hence, we can go for the condition that is theta belongs to, let's say, theta belongs to pi by 2 and greater than minus pi by 2, right? So, minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, we have to consider for this only result. So, let's see. Anyhow, next. So that is, if you solve this, then we find here mod x minus 1 whole square, and that is x belongs to all real number. And hence we say, for the range of this, we say y belongs to minus pi by 2 plus pi by 2. Now substituting the x equal to tan theta, for defining the curve x equal to tan theta, we can say sine versus sine 2 theta. If you see the graph of sine versus sine 2 theta, then the graph goes like this way. Let's see here. The graph goes like this way. Here we see sine versus sine 2 theta. This is the graph of sine versus sine 2 theta. This is x-axis. This is what you call y-axis. And the graph of sine versus sine 2 theta, you can see here, the graph goes like this way. And so on. Here also, the same pattern, and so on. Let's say this is pi by 2. This length will be also pi by 2. This is here, you know, minus pi by 2. Yeah. And this is 3 pi by 2, you can say. And this is pi here. So this line will be y equal to x. And this line will be y equal to, you know, that is pi minus. It will intersect at pi. So you say this is pi minus x. This is a graph of, you know, you can say here theta. If you are using theta, then you can say theta, because f, that is sine inverse. This is the graph of sine inverse sine theta. This is the graph of sine inverse sine theta. So here we are using y equal to pi minus theta, and here we are using this one. The graph is y equal to this one minus pi. That is minus pi and minus theta, right? And similarly, here you can say y equal to, that is pi, this one is 2 pi, you know. So we can say later on minus 2 pi and plus theta. Although this is not in use, later on we'll show, check this, let's say. So for this all, if 2 theta is greater than pi by 2, we have to say for sine versus 2 theta. You have to replace all the theta with 2 theta here. So 2 theta is less than pi by 2, you have to go for pi minus 2 theta as per right side, left side graph. And between minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, that is simple y equal to x type of line. You see here, if I draw over here the graph of sine versus sine 2 theta, this is the case, this one, and this is the case like this, and this is the case like this. So you know, this is pi by 2, this length is pi by 2. So ahead to pi by 2, that is the line pi minus 2 theta, this one. Here we have drawn the graph of sine versus sine 2 theta, and there we have shown that is sine versus sine theta, sine theta. So here sine versus sine 2 theta, that will be pi minus 2 theta. Here it will be 2 theta, and here this will be y equal to, that is what we call minus pi minus 2 theta. So minus pi minus 2 theta, we are using this type of graph, this line, this very line, you say, you know, this very line is corresponding to this part, yeah? And this y equal to 2 theta, this part, and this, that is y equal to pi minus 2 theta, this part. So this is sine versus sine 2 theta graph. Now substituting here, that is the what we saw call here theta, that is x equal to tan versus x, you can say. Here this provides theta equal to, you know, that is tan inverse x, whereas theta was minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. So here you say theta equal to tan versus x. Now substitute over here theta at this place, and each and every place this. So we say y equal to pi minus 2 tan inverse x, where tan inverse x is greater than pi by 4. 2 tan inverse x lies between minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4. Why this becomes pi by 4? Here you have to divide with this 2, 2, if you are dividing both sides, then you will get minus pi by 4 and plus pi by 4. And here that is minus pi minus 2 tan inverse x, that is tan inverse x is less than minus pi by 4. This is the result. So you say this part. Hence we say y equal to pi minus 2 tan inverse x. And formally, if you solve this, then you will find as tan inverse x is greater than pi by 4, that is x is greater than 1, and here tan inverse x lies between minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4, corresponding to this x lies between minus pi 1 to plus 1, and this one is x less than minus 1 as it is less than minus pi by 4. So this will be minus pi minus 2 tan inverse x, and pi minus 2 tan inverse x, and 2 tan inverse x. So if you draw the graph of this all, then you will find the graph like this way. How this graph comes, let's see. So the graph of actually y equal to 2 sine inverse 2 x upon 1 plus x square is defined for x belongs to all real number and y belongs to minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2 closed interval. So the graph of the equation 1 could be the shown in the figure like this way. Now, but how this comes, if you see here in detail, so let me analyze over here. As you know, this is the graph. You can differentiate this 2 tan inverse x result, and here then what we find here, concavity is upward. Here concavity is downward, here you say concavity upward, here concavity once again downward. Here from minus 1 to plus 1 we can show this, that there is an increasing function, and here beyond x is 1, x equal to 1, that is decreasing function, and less than minus 1, that is also this one is decreasing function. It's okay, as x is increasing, y is decreasing over here. So you can show over here, this is increasing and decreasing. How you can show this? Let's see. So if the graph is like this way, y equal to pi minus 2 tan inverse x. So if you differentiate here, then you know here the conditions are, that is, first let me write, note down the condition. That is condition R, that is if fx is any fx, that what we call here, any fx, if f dash x is positive, then this implies fx is increasing function. Fx is increasing function, and here f dash x is, so I am giving a tip over here. So but here you have to check the function should be differentiable also. Less than 0, then fx is decreasing over here. This is also called SMI. Detail we will go and discuss in the chapter of monotonicity, and that is also called SMD. SMD means strictly monotonic increasing function, and here that is strictly monotonic decreasing function. And you know, if f double dash x is positive, f double dash x is positive, it means concavity is upward. Concavity is upward. And f double dash is negative. Double dash means second derivative of function at x equal to whatever the point or whatever the interval there is, which is in which we have to analyze it. So here what we say, concavity is downward. Concavity is downward. It means if we conclude here, then we have to differentiate this and check the increasing and decreasing function. So if you see here, then let me change this color. So that what we say here, if you differentiate this, that is dy by dx for this one, dy by dx, then what we conclude over here, that is pi minus 2, you know, tan inverse x differential is 1 upon 1 plus x square. That is here when that is x is greater than 1, and when x belongs to minus 1 to plus 1, it mean for this one open interval, here there is closed interval, minus 1 to plus 1. So that is 2 upon 1 plus x square, what we conclude over here, let's see. And when x is less than 1, you know, less than minus 1 here. So or you say this also, we can say somehow mod x is that is less or equal to 1, and here that is x is less than minus 1. If x is less than minus 1, that is minus pi differentiation, that is constant, that is 0, and here that is also constant differential is 0, and here that what we call here minus 2 upon, that is minus 2 upon 1 plus x square, right? Minus 2 upon 1 plus x square. It means beyond x's, what we conclude? We can conclude over here that dy by dx means f dash x. F dash x is positive. When it is positive, only in this case. When x is mod x is less or equal to 1. Mod x is, that is less or equal to 1. And if mod x is greater than 1, then here f dash x is negative. It means in this case, the function is increasing over here. And in this case, function is decreasing. So beyond minus 1 to plus 1, function is decreasing. And between minus 1 to plus 1, function is increasing in nature. And if you double if you check the double derivative over here, let's see f double dash x. If you see f double dash x here, then differentiation of using quotient rule means, or yeah, 1 by x, so negative of 1 by x differential is negative of 1 by x whole square. So if you differentiate over here, then you will find once again that is negative of negative, that will become positive. And here 2x, that is x is positive, so here concavity is upward. But when you check here, then what you will find here, once again negative negative positive, and but once again here that is 2x, and due to that x in numerator, due to this negative in nature, here the concavity will be downward. So here in this case concavity is downward and concavity is upward. But here also once again the two cases arises over here. Negative of you will find 2x upon 1 plus x whole square. So that we say x for negative, that it will be once again concavity will be downward, and here the in positive concavity will be upward. So you can see over here that we get the graph like this way. So let's see. So the graph is here. Here if you see, as we have already checked in this bracket minus 1 to plus 1 in this interval, the function was strictly increasing over there, and here the function is decreasing, and here also the function is decreasing undoubtedly. But if you check here in negative era, that is concavity downward here, and in positive, that is concavity upward. Here also when we are making a double derivative, that was a concavity downward and concavity downward, and here concavity is upward. I can also give a tip on this all, that how to check the concavity and this one increasing and decreasing concepts. So let's see over here. So in this to verify, just I will make the four different cases, means such type of way we will find only four different cases are there like this. So here we make four cases. In first case, if we make f dash as positive and f double dash is also positive, here we make f dash positive, and here that what we say f double dash negative, here we say f dash is negative, and here f double dash is also negative, here what we say, that is f dash is once again, that is negative, and f double dash we have to check as f double dash x is also negative. Here we have considered negative, so f double dash x we have to consider as positive, no? Yes, f double dash x you consider as positive. So we see here f double dash x is positive. So in this case, what we see here, in above first and second cases, in above top cases, function is increasing in nature. Here the function is increasing in nature, here also function is increasing in nature, and here in this case function is decreasing in nature. So but you see over here that the, what about the concavity? So in the mean of concavity, as f double dash x positive, concavity is upward, here concavity is downward, here once again concavity is upward, so here concavity is downward. So how to manage this such a graph here? So if you see, the graph goes like this way. We have to make the concavity upwards and function is also increasing. So if we draw here simple x-axis over here and y-axis as like this way, the graph should be like this type of nature. So means concavity is also upward and function is also increasing. So like this type of nature, this is x-axis and this what you call y-axis. And if you draw the graph like this way, here let's say this is x-axis and let's say this is y-axis. So f dash is negative, positive, f dash is positive concave function is increasing, and f double dash x is negative concavity is downward. So the graph will be goes like this way. So the pattern of the graph should be like this way. Here once again, if you draw the graph here, so in any mean, whenever you find like this type of situation, so f dash is negative means decreasing, and f double dash positive concavity is upward. So concavity is upward, but the function is decreasing in nature. So the graph should be like this way. Means concavity is upward and function is decreasing. As x is increasing, function is y value is decreasing. So, but when you draw the graph over here like this, this is x axis, this is what you call y axis. So if f dash is negative and f double dash is also negative, means concavity is also downward, function is also decreasing. So here decreasing nature and concavity downward, so the graph will be goes like this way. So here there are the four combination of graphs. So in each and every section you will find this such four combinations. So let's see over here. So when we are differentiating here, so in positive 0 to 1, what we find here, these are x positive. So while differentiating, we get here the negative, this one positive result. So function is increasing, means mod x is less or equal to, means that is f dash when we were differentiating, then we find f dash was positive for mod x is less or equal to 1 we found. And here what we found there, for mod x is greater than 1, for mod x is greater than 1, that is f dash x is, that is was negative. So that it means decreasing in nature, and here increasing in nature. So you see, here the graph is decreasing, here also the graph is decreasing, and here the graph is increasing, in this bracket graph is increasing. But what about the concavity pattern? So if you see here concavity pattern, so there are the two cases here. For positive x here, this one concavity is downward, and here that is concavity is upward for x greater than 1. And for x less than minus 1, that was a negative. So that is the here due to this one, here there is negative, so concavity is downward. You can double differentiate and check whether how you get the concavity downward and upward. And by making the combination of that in four quadrants, what we have discussed the graph here for concavity and increasing and decreasing, you can manage the graph and you will find this such a graph will be there. In later on, we will discuss more detail on other graphs also. So let's go ahead. So finally, now let's try to yourself to sketch the graph of cos inverse 1 minus x square upon 1 plus x square. How you see cos inverse 1 minus x square upon 1 plus x square, that what we call over here, that is means once again the domain of cos inverse x is also, that is x lies between minus 1 to plus 1. So that we say here minus 1 minus x square upon 1 plus x square mod is less or equal to 1. So as both of them are positive, so 1 minus x square mod is less or equal to 1 plus x square, which is true for all x, and hence we say x belongs to all real number. Once again here, in the as x belongs to all real number, we can substitute, that is x equal to tan theta. So here, and under the condition, if you find the range over here, then that is there due to this cos inverse, what is the range? That is 0 to pi. The graph of cos inverse lies between 0 to pi, so that is why this is the range here. So let's say define the curve, that is x equal to tan theta. So if you are going for cos inverse 1 minus tan square theta upon 1 plus tan square theta, that will be the formula you say over here, 1 minus tan square theta, 1 plus tan square theta, that is cos 2 theta, safely we can say. We have already learned in trigonometry. So we say cos inverse cos 2 theta, and cos inverse cos 2 theta graph, if you see over here the graph, I can show you the graph here. For this cos inverse cos 2 theta, the graph pattern is like this way. This is y-axis, this is what you call x-axis, and here that is, say, oh, this is y-axis, and cos inverse cos 2 theta, the graph goes like this way, 0 to pi, and here, then there is pi, and such mountain-like structure, that's okay, this here graph, and that. This one, the line y equal to x, this point is, you know, there is pi, once again, this is pi length, and if you extend this line, it will intersect at 2 pi. So that is y equal to 2 pi minus x, and that is y equal to minus x. Although no need of this all, only you have to go for this part of the graph and this part of the graph. So y equal to x and y equal to minus x. So cos inverse cos 2 theta, that is minus 2 theta for positive and minus 2 theta for negative. So you divide here then and substitute over theta as that what we call tan inverse x. So theta, that was tan inverse x, substitute over there. So finally we say 2 tan inverse x, and here that is tan inverse x. And hence you can draw the graph 2 tan inverse x if tan inverse x is positive and tan inverse x is negative. So substituting, that was x equal to tan theta over here, we find this result. So 2 tan inverse x is when tan inverse x is positive, so means x is positive, and minus 2 tan inverse x when x is negative. Now you can differentiate and check. So this is the graph of 2 tan inverse x, and when you differentiate 2 tan inverse x here, then you will find that is positive, because the graph is 1 upon 1 plus x square. And here if you differentiate, then the result of this one is minus 1 upon 1 plus x square. So let me differentiate this to understand over here. As the graph is here cos inverse 1 minus x square upon 1 plus x square, for this if you differentiate 2 tan inverse x, that is 2 upon 1 plus x square, and for this minus 2 upon 1 plus x square. So in this case here that is increasing and here that is decreasing. And if you double differentiate, then you will find that for positive and negative, in the both the cases you will find the negative result for differentiation. So hence the concavity is downward. So concavity is also downward and function is also increasing and decreasing. So concave, the open leaf type of structure is there. This is the final graph of this, which is visible. Now let's say for third question, that is y equal to tan inverse 2x upon 1 minus x square. Here the domain 2x upon 1 minus x square, once again this is an all real number because due to tan inverse. So if you solve this, then that is 1 minus x square, where except 1 minus x square is 0. So where is x square? 1 minus x square vanishes when x belongs to 1 and minus 1. So except 1 and minus 1, you have to go for all real number. So its domain is all real number, difference minus 1 to plus 1. And the range is, that is tan inverse 2x upon 1 minus x square. And hence the y belongs to minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. So you see, this is the domain and range. So you, here you can show this, see that you can substitute x equal to tan theta. So applying the formula 2 tan theta upon 1 minus tan square theta, we get tan 2 theta, and hence tan was tan 2 theta. If you draw the graph of tan was tan theta, then the graph shows like this here. So the pattern of the graph is like this way. Tan inverse tan x graph, let me draw over here. Tan inverse tan x graph, that is, let this be x axis, and here the graph you show like this way. So let this be y axis, and this what you call x axis. Here let me draw x-axis, this is x-axis, you know, and here that is y-axis. This is what you call y-axis. So the graph of tan inverse tan x, if you see, the graph is like this way. Here the graph goes like this way. Here this is, these are the point pi by 2 and minus pi by 2, and once again here you have to go like this way. These are the rough sketch, you know, this is pi by 2, and here once again this is minus pi by 2. So you have to make like this way. This is the line y equal to x, you know, and this is the line y equal to, that is this point is, you know, this is my pi. So y equal to, we can write minus pi plus x, so x minus pi you can say, and here once again that is y equal to x plus pi. So you see, this is the line y equal to x, you can draw properly over here. These all three lines, white lines, are parallel, and hence we say this is the graph. So here we say this is pi plus x and this is minus pi plus x, and that is x. So that is what we say here, 2 theta is less than means whatever we have drawn. That if we draw the graph over here, the graph pattern is here like this.
this is the line y equal to x line, this is the line y equal to pi minus x. You can make our circle also here, and here like this another circle, and like this. So this is the line here, this is the part of graph y equal to pi plus, you said this is 2 theta, and here that is y equal to 2 theta. We can write over here, this is let the y axis, this is x axis, and y equal to, you say pi, that is minus pi plus 2 theta, last one. So that is my minus pi plus 2 theta for this line. So this line will be 2 theta is greater than pi by 2, right? So here what we say, substituting the value of theta over there, that is pi plus 2 tan inverse x, tan inverse x is less than minus pi by 4, and 2 tan inverse x, that is tan inverse x, less than minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4, and minus pi plus 2 tan inverse x, there when tan inverse x is greater than pi by 4. So solving this, what we say here, the graph pattern is like this way. The result is here, that is pi plus 2 tan inverse x when x is less than minus 1, because that is the corresponding to value, that one minus pi by 4, and here between minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4, that we say 2 tan inverse x, and here when we go for x greater than 1, that is minus pi plus 2 tan inverse x, just substituting the value of theta as tan inverse x over here. So the final result is this one, and if you differentiate this, that is 1 plus 1 upon 1 plus x square. Here this is positive in nature, the function is increasing pattern. Here also minus pi differential is 0. Once again, if you find here increasing pattern, here also function is increasing pattern. So what do you get here? Finally, the function has an increasing in nature throughout. And while in different double derivative for check for concavity, and here in as it is in negative era, so concavity, yes, that will be downward. And here, but if you differentiate here, you can check the result, because 2 upon 1 plus x square, differentiation of 1 upon 1 plus x square is equal to negative of 2x upon 1 plus 1 upon 1 plus x square whole square, and 2 is already over there. So we find x is negative over there, negative negative positive, so concavity will be upward here, yes, and here that will be concavity will be downward, and hence here once again there is the two cases here. And that is negative and positive both. In this case, here there is a negative and positive both. So in negative case and positive case, you differentiate and check the graph is like this way. So here the pattern of the graph is like this. Let me see once again. So the graph is like this way. You see, that is pi plus 2 tan inverse x. This one is increasing, here also you say increasing, here also you see increasing, throughout increasing in nature. Here that is concavity upward, here concavity upward, now once again concavity downward and concavity downward. If you see in positive era, concavity is downward, and here in negative era, that is concavity is upward. So that is increasing and concavity is upwards. Here increasing throughout in graph is increasing in nature. So similar pattern you go tan inverse 3x minus x cube upon 1 minus 3x square also. So I'm skipping this one, and you can check and you try yourself. So skipping next one, and I will jump on fifth question directly. So let's see. Now sine inverse 3x minus 4x cube. So you see how to find the domain over here, 3x minus 4x cube. That is the domain here, that is sine inverse x lies between minus 1 to plus 1. So you know that is here we have to go for domain like this way. So let me find the domain as y fx was, that is sine inverse 3x minus 4x cube. That what we call 3x minus 4x cube. So you know 3x minus 4x cube, this should lies between minus 1 to plus 1. This is less or equal to 1. And here, you know, that is greater or equal to minus 1. So you have to solve the two inequalities separately, and then you have to make the intersection. So let's solve. So if you are going to solve here, then you transpose first inequality I am solving. So 4x cube minus transpose it minus 3x and minus 1 is less or equal to 0. So how to solve this? You can use here either by Horner process or any way, you just have to factorize it. So if you are going to factorize, then what we see over here, let's see how to factorize it. Let you write 4 and here that is 0, the coefficient of x square. I am using Horner method. So and here the coefficient of x, that is minus 3, and that what we call minus 1. And you just use 1 or minus 1 result. So if we are using 1 over here, then if we are using 1 randomly, we check. So if we get here 4, here you have to make a blank quotient. So 4, that is the same result, and 4 just copy out. 4 ones are 4, and 4 minus 3, that is 1, and 1 ones are 1, and 1 minus 1, 0. So that it means this is the result here, 4, 4, 1. So this we can say here, now on factorizing, so this factor can be evaluated as simply here. You here on this position you get the multiple also and factor also. So its factor will be, due to this one as a multiplier, so due to one, so one is the factor, so x minus one is one of the factor of this result, and another factor will be quadratic. So because this is the 3-degree polynomial, cubic polynomial, and so linear already ruled out, and the quadratic will be left, and the coefficients are 4x square plus 4x plus 1. So simply you can get here 4x square plus 4x and plus 1. 1 you have to note down, and this one is less or equal to 0, you know. This one you have to make 0. So finally what we say here, x minus 1 into, and you just now solve this 4x square, just copy out 4x square plus 4x and plus 1, that we say here less or equal to 0. Now how to solve this inequality? You know, if you check this here quadratic, then what is its discriminant? Discriminant is b square, that is 16, minus 4ac. So that what we say here, discriminant is 16 minus 4ac. Yes, and that is so for what we say here, discriminant is 0. Yes, b square, let me see, discriminant, that is 16 and minus 4ac. Yes, so there is discriminant is 0, so that is becoming 0 over here. So what we say here, that is x minus 1, yes, x minus 1, and here we can say that is 2x plus 1 whole square. Okay, yes, 2x plus 1 whole square is less or equal to 0. So what we find here, we can identify, then here x equal to, it is going to vanish as at x equal to minus, this will be always positive, this will be always get positive. So x is always less or equal to 1, x is always less or equal to 1, and besides here minus 1 by 2, it's also 0. So all the values which are less than 1 will satisfy here. So finally we can get the idea that x is less or equal to 1. This is the part when we are solving the leftward, one of the part of the inequality. When you are solving the another part of the inequality, then here what we get here. Here you can evaluate that x will be greater or equal to minus 1. So if you solve this inequality, then you will find, if you solve the inequality of this part. So let me take another color over here. If you solve the inequality of this part, then what we can find, let me see. So you can say here, 4x cube, right, and then after minus 3x and plus 1, and you have to write greater equal to 0. So here you will get, just put x equal to 1 over here. If you put 1 over here, you will find x equal to minus 1. Yes, minus 1 if you put here, then here you will find this expression becomes 0. So this expressions will become x plus 1 and into something quadratic, that is greater equal to 0. The same pattern you can solve this also. So you will find here also, this will be a perfect square. So x is means greater or equal to 1. So this shows that greater equal to minus 1. Yes, greater equal to minus 1. So making the intersection of these two terms, what we find here, x belongs to minus 1 to plus 1. So the inequality here, the domain is x belongs to minus 1 to plus 1. This is the domain. So corresponding to this, due to the sine inverse, here the domain range is minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. This is the range. And here x equal to sine theta, we have to define the curve. To define the curve, sine inverse sine 3 theta will become, because the formula is 3 sine theta minus 4 sine cube theta, that is sine inverse sine 3 theta. So sine inverse sine theta, if you draw the graph of sine inverse sine x, same pattern like this way. So let me draw the graph of sine inverse sine x over here. So let's see, the graph of sine versus sine x, like let me draw the graph of sine versus sine x. Okay, so draw this as, so to draw the graph of sine versus sine 3 theta, we have to recall over there that sine versus sine theta graph. So let's see sine versus sine 3 theta how to solve over here. Let's see. Sine versus sine 3 theta can be drawn as sine versus sine x. So let's see, this is the x-axis. Let me eliminate this. Let's see. Graph of sine versus sine 3 theta. This is the pattern of sine versus sine x. And like this. So here also the graph is like this way. This part pi by 2, this is minus pi by 2, this is the line y equal to x, you know, and this is the point pi, so this is the line y equal to pi minus x, and here this is the line y equal to minus pi plus x, and this is what you call y axis, this is x axis, and hence we say this is the graph of sine or sine theta. So we have to use this portion and we have to use this portion in the graph. So let's see. So we have to go for pi minus 3 theta and 3 theta. So it means what the graph we have drawn over here, that was one of the graph is, that is y equal to 3 theta, and the graph which is further curved from up to this in pi, and from pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2, that is between minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, that is y equal to x line, that is 3 theta, and between pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2, that is pi minus 3 theta. Here that is y equal to, that what we call pi minus 3 theta, and here that is y equal to 3 theta, you know, and then after we have to go the graph like this way. So this is the graph when minus 3 pi by 2, when this one is minus 3 pi by 2, this part is minus 3 pi by 2 to minus pi by 2. So in this line will be y equal to pi minus 3 theta, minus pi minus 3 theta, and here this is pi by 2, and this what you call 3 pi by 2. From this 3 pi by 2, once again the graph goes like this way. So the graph has the three different definitions on the condition between y lie between minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. So for pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2, that is pi minus 3 theta, minus pi by 2 to minus 3 pi by plus pi by 2, that is 3 theta, and minus 3 pi by 2 to minus pi by 2, that is minus pi minus 3 theta. So that is the graph over here, and let's see how to find, substituting the value of theta over tan sine versus x there, that is, that will become pi minus 3 sine versus x. Everywhere, wherever there is theta, you have to substitute sine versus x, and dividing by this 3 here, that we say pi by 6, and here that will become pi by 2, and here that is minus pi by 6 to minus plus pi by 6, and here also minus pi by 2 to minus pi by 6. In this situation, corresponding to sine versus values, you will get 1 by 2, and here that is 1. So pi minus 3 sine versus x lies between x, when x lies between 1 by 2 to 1, and when x lies between minus 1 by 2 to plus 1 by 2, that is 3 sine versus x, and when x lies between minus 1 to minus 1 by 2, that is minus pi minus 3 sine inverse x. This is the graph. Now for the graph, you just differentiate this and check how the concavity and increasing and decreasing. So sine versus 3x minus 4x cube, the graph pattern is like this way, that is sine versus 3x minus 4x cube, pi minus 3 sine versus x, and 3 sine versus x, pi minus pi minus 3 sine versus x, and like x lies between 1 by 2 to 1, and x lies between minus 1 by 2 to plus 1 by 2, and x lies between minus 1 to minus 1 by 2 for negative error. So you see here, then what we see over here, if we go and differentiate this first part, 3 sine versus x, then differentiation of this is 3 upon under root of 1 minus x square. What we can conclude that this is positive, and as it is positive, so this means this is increasing. So between minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, if you see here, this is somehow, that is minus 1 by 2, this part is minus 1 by 2, yes, and here that is plus 1 by 2. So between this, if you see, the graph is here thoroughly increasing pattern, the graph is increasing pattern, and here in this case, that is concavity upward, and in this case concavity is downward. So if you differentiate here once again, then here there will be the two cases here. For differentiation of this, minus 2x will be there. So for the negative portion, x is negative, so negative negative will become positive, and here, and due to this root 1 upon 2 root, this one, the once again that will be negative, so concavity is downwards over here for negative. And for positive error, that is concavity is upward, and once again here if you see, this is the negative portion, so the result will be change once again, there is a decreasing pattern here, and here also the pattern is decreasing, fine. So in this case here concavity is upward and concavity is downward. So finally you can differentiate is twice and check how the concavity and increasing decreasing will be there. Detail you will go on monotonicity chapter also. And also I have given the same pattern in the four different quadrants of f dash and f double dash sine pattern. You can go and see once again the video, rewind it with the video and connect it with this, and you will get the idea of this, the graph. So let's see. So go for another question, same pattern. You can go ahead with yourself, try yourself also. This is the last part, part one, sixth part, that is a sketch of y equal to cos inverse 4x cube minus 3x. The same pattern will be here, 4x cube minus 3x lies between minus 1 to plus 1. Once again applying a Horner pattern, Horner theorems of as like previous, here and go ahead and or you in any other method, just like remainder theorem or in any way, you cubic polynomial, you just factorize it, you will find x minus 1 and x plus 1 type of structure, and other will be discriminant, maybe negative or perfect square, so we will find x belongs to minus 1 to plus 1. You can go do yourself. So and here due to this cos inverse, as you know, the graph of cos inverse is like this way, that is cos inverse graph is here, the pattern of cos inverse x, this is decreasing pattern although, but it's here the range is 0 to pi, you know, this is the graph of cos inverse x, so that is 0 to pi, so the range is also 0 to pi. Okay, so substituting the x equal to cos theta here, that is cos inverse cos 3 theta, and that what we say here, that is 2 pi minus 3 theta and 3 theta and minus 2 pi plus 3 theta, these all can be evaluated by using the graph of cos inverse cos x. Let's say cos inverse cos x, how to draw the cos inverse cos x graph. Let's see, the graph of cos inverse cos x is like this way, this is x axis, you know, and this what you call y axis, and cos inverse cos x pattern is this one, and like this, and like this way, and here this is the pattern, this is y equal to x line, this is going up to pi length, and here that is later on we say that is 2 pi minus x, and here that is y equal to minus x, you know, and this we can say this one, and if you see this one, so y equal to, that is this part is 2 pi, so it extend up to this one minus 2 pi somewhere, so that will be minus 2 pi plus x, so here this and this will be required. So when 3 theta lies between pi to 2 pi, that is 2 pi minus 3 theta, this one is the second portion of the part of the graph, and 3 theta lies between 0 to pi, you know, this is 0 to pi, then that is y equal to x simply, so y equal to 3 theta here, and when 3 theta lies between 2 pi to 3 pi, this one 2 pi to 3 pi here, this is 3 pi you can say. So the graph is here y equal to minus 2 pi plus 3 theta, so minus 2 pi plus theta, substituting over here theta for cos inverse x, theta you can say here cos inverse x, now substitute cos inverse x over here in each and every place, wherever you found theta, you just substitute over here cos inverse x, that is 2 pi minus 3 cos inverse x, here on dividing 3 you will get cos inverse x lies between pi by 3 to 2 pi by 3, similarly cos inverse x lies between 0 to pi by 3, that is 3 cos inverse x, and cos inverse x lies between 2 pi by 3 to pi, that is minus 2 pi plus 3 cos inverse x. and hence you will find the graph like this way. On differentiating this 3 cos inverse x, that is the negative of 1 upon under root 1 minus x square, and check the concavity and increasing pattern, monotonicity increasing or decreasing pattern, and then you can draw the graph safely. So let's see. 2 pi minus 3 cos inverse x, when x lies between minus 1 by 2 to plus 1 by 2, x lies between 1 by 2 to 1, that is 3 cos inverse x, and x lies between minus 1 to 1 minus 1 by 2, minus 2 pi plus 3 cos inverse x. You can find these values by the help of the graph, or you can simply by using the table of the cos theta values wherever that is occurs. You have already studied in class 11th level. So the graph of cos inverse 4x cube minus 3x is 2 pi minus 3 cos inverse x, and 3 cos inverse x, and minus 2 pi plus 3 cos inverse x, according as per x lies between minus 1 by 2 to plus 1 by 2, x lies between 1 by 2 to 1, and x lies between minus 1 to minus 1 by 2. So it can be shown as this one. If you differentiate this 3 cos inverse x, then what the pattern will be according to as per increasing and decreasing. So here you find that in between minus 1 by 2 to plus 1 by 2, once again, as like despite of sine x, sine inverse x, sine inverse 3x minus 4x cube, that is same here increasing pattern. Here also again this is a decreasing pattern, and here also this is a decreasing pattern. So you will find the concavity here upward in when from 0 to this one 1 by 2, and from 1 by 2 to 1, then once again the function is in decreasing pattern. Concavity is downwards here. Here you will find concavity downwards between minus 1 by 2 to 0, and between minus 1 to minus 1 by 2, once again concavity is upward. Although minus root 3 by 2, here there is the point where it crosses the x-axis, and here plus root 3 by 2 is also the point where it crosses the x-axis. So the graph domain is, you see, along x-axis it is spanned over minus 1 to plus 1, and on y-axis it is spanned over 0 to plus pi. So this part, you know, this is the pi, that is called pi. This is the graph of y equal to. You can once again make a practice, and many times making a practice, you are able to understand this very easily. Although there is a sharp corners here there is a sharp corner, and these points function is not differentiable. So if somebody asking the differentiate to the curve of cos inverse this one means 4x cube minus 3x, so that at x equal to 1 by 2 or minus 1 by 2, that is meaningless, means absurd result will be there. Okay, thanks for watching. Fine.